Supreme Master Chinghai's lectures are not a complete meditation instruction. Please do not try alone. For free of charge guidance, please visit www.godsdirectcontact.org or contact any of our centers near you.
Today's episode will be presented in English and Chinese with subtitles in Arabic for Alexis, also known as Vietnamese, Bulgarian, Chinese, Croatian, Dutch, English, French, German, Hindi, Hungarian, Indonesian, Japanese, Korean, Malay, Mongolian, Persian, Polish, Portuguese, Romanian, Spanish, and Thai. Salutări, dragi telespectatori! Eu sunt Bianca din Odorhei, din România, cea pacifistă. România este o țară fascinantă din sud-estul Europei, cu oameni remarcabili. Este binecuvântată cu o diversitate de peisaje naturale, cum ar fi munții Carpați, câmpiile întinse din sud și ghețarii subterani pe locul 2 în Europa ca mărime. România are 8 monumente în patrimoniul mondial desemnat de Organizația Națiunilor Unite pentru Educație, Știință și Cultură, printre care Delta Dunării, pădurile bătrâne de Fagi, din munții Carpați, bisericile din Moldova și Mănăstirea Horezu. Capitala țării este București, este cel mai mare oraș și este centrul cultural și financiar al țării. De asemenea, este și locul Palatului, Parlamentului, care este cea mai mare și mai scumpă clădire administrativă de pe pământ. Este minunat să vă împărtășim o scânteie mică despre România. Noi vă dorim ca toate visele nobile să vi se împlinească în anul nou. Acum să ne bucurăm de partea finală a programului intitulat Iubirea unui maestru viu ajunge la toate ființele. Mai multe limbi sunt valabile online. Pentru limba dumneavoastră specială, vă rugăm vizitați www.suprememastertv.com, varo obligă, subtitles. De peste 3 decenii, Maestra Supremă Chinghai ne-a iluminat lumea noastră prin învățăturile sale divine. Ca maestră complet iluminată, dânsa predă metoda Kuan Yin de meditație celor care doresc să descopere imediat natura de Dumnezeu din interior și să realizeze într-o singură viață eliberarea eternă din ciclul transmigrării. Metoda Kuan Yin a fost practicată de toți maestrii iluminați, cum ar fi Buddha, Iisus Hristos, profetul Mohamed, pacea să fie cu el, și Guru Nanak. Dânsa pune accentul pe faptul că dacă noi ne aducem aminte mereu de Dumnezeu, dacă suntem altruiști și respectăm legile universale, o să ajungem la cel mai înalt potențial ca oameni și o să înțelegem cu adevărat scopul nostru pe pământ. Maestra Supremă Chinghai este un exemplu viu extraordinar al compasiunii, trimitând regulat ajutoare materiale și financiare, precum și iubire refugiaților, celor homeless, victimelor dezastrelor naturale și altora care au nevoie de ajutor. În 2006, dânsa a primit premiul Gusi pentru pace, considerat ca premiul Nobel pentru pace în Asia și a fost onorată de-a lungul anilor cu nenumărate premii și laude pentru faptele sale umanitare și filantropice demne de laudă. Ca o voce adevărată pentru prietenii noștri animalele, dânsa promovează dieta păcii pe bază de produse din plante și întrevede, odată cu trezirea omenirii, la valoarea sacră a tuturor viețuitoarelor. O lume vegană, plină de glorie și pace, unde animalele și oamenii să trăiască fericiți în armonie. Inițiativele sale de a răspândi trendul vegan sunt diverse și includ distribuția fluturașilor, un alt fel de a trăi, lanțul internațional de restaurante vegane La Vinghat, Supreme Master Television, precum și convorbiri dese cu liderii influenți din guverne și presă și participarea la conferințe televizate despre schimbarea climei, indiferent dacă noi suntem conștienți de asta sau nu. Eforturile sale au avut o influență enormă asupra trezării globale la un stil de viață ocrotitor al animalelor și despre cum această cale binevoitoare de a fi poate aduce pacea eternă între toate țările, în timp ce ne salvează planeta de la schimbarea climei. De-a lungul anilor, Maestra Supremă Ching Hai a călătorit în toată lumea, din America până în Africa, din Europa în Asia și a ținut sute de discursuri cu publicul și cu discipolii săi despre diverse subiecte spirituale. Azi, noi suntem binecuvântați să vă prezentăm una din aceste prelegeri interesante intitulată Iubirea unui maestru viu ajunge la toate ființele, partea a 3 din 3, din Între maestră și discipol, ținută în engleză și chineză, pe 6 octombrie 2016, în Hong Kong.
就是如果患者中毒了，就知道他用什么药的话，就用哪个药把它气息了，就可以解毒了。
真的吗？
还真的。还有呢，第二方法呢，就用那个海洗剥血虾，就干虾米的干虾，然后干虾可以解毒的。
是谁说的？这有保证吗？这个波雪茄已经发明了干尸保护的地球，像那个日本的那个富士嘛，也是用这个干尸去解决了问题了。他就是说那个好东西连核辐射都能抵抗掉。
哦，这样子在哪里找到？其实我们自己在家里都可以做的，然后现在在意大利已经免费的教学，有一百三十多堂课了，免费的课程，就专门传授这个好经验的。哦，太好了，太好了。
这个干尸呢，可以记住自由人员免费的这种。哦，太好了。还有呢，可以记住水，记住空气，也可以解毒。啊哈，
大概是地下的人有没有传上去一些？
他们是会做这样子。 就现在追随他的人，学生啊，全世界都有，他的学生也有用这个功能来替人家治疗啊，这样。 它就是说它有那个非常好的治疗的功能，所以这个好东西不仅用于军方、官方、民间，它可以产生跟水和自然能源结合在一起，对狗狗的那个治疗和帮助，还有解毒，抗那些相当于毒药的那种疫苗呢，可以有很大的作用。
我们在家里怎么弄呢？但是我们家里可以弄。
我家里我就想做一个芯片，一个纳米桶，
再来
一个电线，下面放一点盐水。
我有听过。
它自己就长起来了，它自己都有做成功，就长了好多。
长什么？
长出来的那种
像众生一样。
对，像众生一样，是一种又像菌类又像植物的一种东西吧，是不是？哦，植物在宇宙中其实很多地方都存在，有在植物中，在宇宙中，在我们的人体都存在有这个东西，所以应该对狗狗有很大帮助的。这个科学家自己被毒害的，中的那个毒，他用这个真的是解到了的。
OK， 是不是 MRI？
像不像酵素？它不是酵素，它是人体里头都存在的，植物里面也存在的，是非常优质的，是
OK
顶尖的那种东西，很难。
也许有效。
哦，最近几天，好多师姐这几天在山上干活的时候，劳动的时候，被蚊子咬了以后，用的那个真的马上就有效果了。
OK。是他自己去学习吗？
对，
他自己去学习。他那个是有一点像那个电解一样的东西，他里面一个芯片，一个纳米的桶的，然后连起来之后放在那个里面，他们会自动生成。他说的是真丝一样的东西，就是像金丝一样的，有一些像金属一样的东西，他用来说是解毒的，就那个东西用来解毒。但是不是金属，一个晶体了，那个 crystal box。
晶体的意思是啊 ，gas in nano state。There are four kind of state in the material. Solid state, gas in nano state, in soft form.
哦，这样子，不是众生哈。
不是。
好了解，因为他说生出来很多，我们认为是生上去。OK， 谢谢了，好了。OK， 我再想看看啊，谢谢了，谢谢。如果有这样效果的话，也是对世界有用啊，对大家有用，我也很高兴啊。再想看看 ，OK， 谢谢。师
傅你好，就是睡起来就感觉一个人不高兴，不知道为什么，就是。
啊，是不是打坐不够，不是吃什么不对，不知道的。
他不清楚。
嗯，你在做什么工作呢？
没有。
没有工作。
啊。
就整天睡觉，起来就不高兴。能够这样睡觉的，就很好了。
做家务。
家庭主妇，那你这么好运。啊。
谢谢。
我连现在家也没有。OK， 那有时候你睡觉的时间不对，懂吗？比方说那个时候大，突然那个世界影响了。OK， 如果睡觉，比方说中午睡太多，或是下午那时间，人家那个时候很烦闷了，整个世界了，懂不懂？烦闷了，然后你睡觉的时候就没有那种抵抗力了，了解？然后他们就会。攻击了，那种气氛会攻击你，所以想睡觉的时候，如果能够忍耐的话，就不要睡那个时候 ，OK？ 啊，然后在那边尽量打坐而不睡觉。
好的。
啊，打坐完以后，如果还很累就可以睡 ，OK？
哦，好。
哎，这样就不会被那种气氛包围，然后攻击，了解？
哦，是这样的。
哎嘿嘿，有时候我们大家一样了，不是你了啊。我是像那个刚才那个小孩子问那个东西了，要是我累了，然后睡了，我是想就为那个世界那种气氛呢攻击的，才觉得恐慌或是空白。OK， 那马上再打坐就好了，不然的话去做什么？如果不能打坐，那个时候就去做别的事情了，解闷了。 吃你最喜欢吃的东西也好了，不要那么严格严肃了 ，OK？ 吃你最喜欢的，我是跟你最好的朋友聊一聊了，我是跟说你信任的同修聊一聊这样子。如果不然的话，看师傅影片，如果还能够的话，再解闷一下，好 ，OK？ 师姐也是一样 ，OK？
嗯，那怎么回事啊？
就
这样
子，
睡起来
还
是感觉不高兴。
知道了，知道了。不要睡。比方说，你经常中午有睡觉，了解吗？然后起来不好，就比如说那个时候，最好不要睡觉，打坐 ，OK？ 打坐完以后还累的话，还睡一下，懂吗？那个时候最少已经有保护力量了 ，OK？
啊，谢谢。
啊，不客气。啊，不客气。不客气，
我这个体验呢，还是清楚了。
是我先生。
生活上的，心里想什么的，这么奇怪的，自然的就实现了。看师傅的时候，听到师傅说，现在我就，哎呀，我现在不能解释了，我去那个秋会又不能走，我又80多岁了，
80多岁，
我马上赢了。
不可能的，你看你这么年轻，
真的吗？
真的。
哇，恭喜了，你看起来像40岁。
是啊。那么10年以后又看到这，再度看到你，我很开心。我你说我有机会了，我里边四五个，我说你还要看，好好修，有机会了。
是啊。
出去也不行。
对。
今天一想到是高兴的什么，师傅竟然又来了。
对了，我想说，哦，没骗你。
谢谢师傅。
嗯，你高兴就好了。你现在看起来像40岁左右，有没有？哎呀，那我来这里请你。
我有一个修行的问题，
尽量。
我想问的话就是修行的等级高低和那个修行的体验，这修行越高的话体验会越好吗？
不一定，不一定，看你的头脑永远被挡住了，因为修行有时候高的就不知道体验了，懂吗？你睡觉的时候有吗？懂吗？
因为听到其他同学有分享很高的体验，然后觉得自己很惭愧。
有一些有吗？不一定是每个人都有。
觉得师父在内在外都会很爱我们，因为师父真的不想。
你高兴就 OK 了吗？
真的好感恩师父，我为了找到师父，我找了三辈子找到师父。
上辈子。
对，我都有看到。
对呀、啊，这样子我没体验。
对呀、啊。
看几个太阳还嫌弃不好了，去找什么？
我不一定体验很好，但是我很相信师傅，
对，
一直走下去，
这样就 OK 了。
所以师傅，我真的很希望你能够保护好自己的身体，我没有任何的祈求，我只希望师傅身体健康。
好吧 ，Thank you。下一个，这里啊。
My question is that is it we continue to live our life positively and also take the meditation most important and also love from the heart、the love.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. I don't know how to say, but I feel your.The love from you shining outside everybody. I just wish whatever the people I meet, we have love and we serve each other. I don't know, it is. 我不知道怎么说啊，就是说，我觉得你充满了很多很多很善的、很光亮的爱。我是很喜欢呢，见到那个每一个人对每一个人都充满爱 ，so I just want everybody to have love, just like you. I feel really happy when you talk to us that in Hong Kong so many love, because you bring a lot to Hong Kong.
Okay.
Thanks so much.
I really love.
Recently, I changed my life because I take actions, and then I just pretended to teach other people this.
I love.
Yeah. Okay. It can secure every problem. I do not know if it's right or not.
It's
but
right.
I'm trying to do it.
Okay. It's good. I really love everything.
Yeah. And
then
I really love you.
I really love. I wish all of you know this kind of love. I love even the little ants, the snails, there's a snake around the ashram. Sometimes I talk to them, wonder if they have enough food and they have water and they say okay. But if I eat something, I share with them. I really don't share because it's the right thing to do. I share because I really love them. I really concerned with their life, you know, with the snake, whether he has enough food, and the insect, whether they have water and all that. Understand all the birds. Every day, I feel that I love them so much, but I cannot do much for them. Understand? But I'm just very, very concerned, and I truly love them.
I know.
There was one little cricket coming to my house and jump on my hair, and they jump on my hand, and it just because their grip is kind of sharp, you know, so I automatically shake it. Oh, and I feel so bad. I go look around all over for him 1 hour. So where are you? Come back. I take you out because it's not free inside the house. You know, you might get hurt or you have nothing to eat. Show yourself to me. And all the while he was just there, and I said, you have to show yourself to me now. I say sorry enough, huh? And then then I saw it's on my table. It was right there, you know, very near. I just shook a little gently, and then I took him out. Huh? I used a clear cup, and then put a very thin paper, like cotton, something like that, or plastic, you know, sheet. Put him out, and I put him on the tree outside, on the leaf high. I say, because I don't want to put him down on the ground. Maybe the ants will bite him. They know nothing about ahimsa, you know. Oh, I feel so happy the whole night because I can free him. I can find him, or her, you know, and free her instead. I feel so sorry to have shaken her away like that. I won't worry if she's hurt or something, but not. I have a basket where I put all my working daily, and then she just stay on top of the handle of the basket, all the way looking at me, watching me looking for her everywhere, until the last second, then she forgave me or something. You know, and then I know where she is, and I come and take her out, and she don't refuse. She wants it to let me know that she's in the house so that I will free her. That's all. I'm looking at her everywhere on the floor, no head. All the while she was just standing on my basket and don't move. Yeah, let me, watching me suffer, repent and all. Oh, I really love her. And then when I touch her already, oh, good girl, good girl. And then she goes. Yeah. So we make peace, you know? But even the ants and all that, I worry, so I tell my assistant, don't step on the grass just to clean the leaves, you know? So don't step on. We use the rake, yeah? Yeah, to take the leaves out from one side and another. Or use the machine to blow the leaves away to somewhere else that we can clean the hand better. Because the grass is full of grasshoppers. When I first went on that grass area in front of my cave, wow, hundreds of thousands of them just suddenly all jump in the air, you know? Oh wow, so much. Normally I don't see it. And then when I step on that grass, not on the grass, on the stone that we put on the grass, immediately all of them come in, wow, maybe 100,000 of them. And then just, you know, fly jumping, and then I say, okay, I know you're there, just go back where you're safe. And then they all go back into the grass, under the grass. So I tell them, don't go step on because you might hurt them or kill them. I really feel for them. I really love them. Truly like that. Yeah. Because they cannot help themselves. It feels like I love them more than I love you, but it's not like that. Maybe like that, but maybe not. It's because they're more helpless, you know? I told my assistant, because when I go out to work at night, sometimes I have to go back to the office to work. So they came and shined a flashlight for me. I said, no, no, you put the flashlight in front of you, yourself so that you can see if any insect, because they are helpless. I can help myself. I have my telephone, which I use also as a flashlight. So I look for where I'm walking. You look for where you're walking. You don't worry too much about me. Then you forget. You might step on all the insects because I really feel for them. You know, their life is helpless, understand? It's so small. People don't care. They don't see. We are human. We can take care of ourselves, you know? So do not complain about your problem. You're very lucky people. You already are human. You can do many things which other beings cannot do. The tree, you know, they're just standing there, and the wind, typhoon blowing them and breaking them, they cannot do anything. The insects, you know, the ants, they cannot do anything. They just take care of the family, they risk their life to go on the street, to go on everywhere. You know, they can get killed, they can get stepped on, but they don't mind because they take care of their family and their members, understand? So we are human. We're perfect. You know, eyes, nose, ears, hands, feet. And now can even drive car, have iPod, have every comfort possible. But all these insects, they are so helpless, understand? So it looks like I love them more. I feel that way, but it's not like that. Just helpless one, you know? I feel more sympathy. I really love them so much. I wish I could do everything for everybody. All the beings, you know? But this world is like this. Okay? Truly, I love them so much. You have no idea. And one time after I told the assistant, I just think like that, that the grasshopper, big one, came out, you know, when I go out to the, from my cave to the office to work, they jump in front of me and stay there for a long time. Want to thank me. Last night I rescued a baby, and then now I tell the assistant, don't hurt them, don't walk on the grass. Therefore, you see, the grass is only there to cool the roof, but not for us to step on. And they even put a table on it, two chairs there for me. I said, no, 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 take them away. I would not go in there anymore. Since I saw many crickets, you know, crickets, I don't want to walk in there anymore. I just walk on the step stone just a little bit, not on the grass, okay? You guys also be careful when you're walking, huh? There are many beings under there. Some little, not just cricket, but some little insects, you know? Or maybe May Caver or something? Lady Lucky? Lady May Caver? Yeah. They're under the grass. So careful. We don't really need to picnic and all that, okay? Just check it out where you walk, okay? Yeah. You done?
Yeah, I done it.
Yeah.
Even though.
Yeah, thank you. The next one behind it. You're welcome. I'm glad you feel my love.
Yeah. I feel. So, even though at home, I don't feel the mosquito, my mother said, why you get a mosquito? Ooh, go away.
Yeah.
Like that.
Okay. So at least I can infect you with my love.
You will.
Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
我想问一下，就看见佛经，十二因缘，你知道十二因缘？我没时间解释那么多，因为就看佛经就知道了，写很清楚，OK？就是这样而已哈，不用管了，十二二十都不管了，你去观念就OK了。上次我讲很多事情嘛，比方说我们要做这个，要做那个，要做那个嘛，才好嘛。那佛也是那个时候也解释嘛。 啊，应该这个好，这个不好，那个，所以他那个时候众生喜欢那样嘛，他就讲这样的嘛，哎，十二因缘呐，然后八正道啊，佛那不出，好多了。 他都是号码的 OK， 我是随便讲，我没有说要十二个条件要弄，我是十三个条件要弄，懂吗？一样啊，同样啊 OK， 差不多了。
Hi Master.
Hi.
I'm so surprised and overjoyed to see you again after 10 years. Last time we met was in Thailand.
Yes.
And you gave me free teddy bears, including two sisters.
Is he there?
Yeah, they are behind. And however, we lost it.
It's okay, somebody else.
I would like to represent for my family to beg for your forgiveness.
No.
From losing your love. The teddy bears.
No, you don't lose my love, you just lose some bears. Besides, somebody else might pick them up and enjoy them. It's the same, okay?
You're
welcome. I don't say anything. If you lost it, you lost it. Somebody else is happy to pick them up, okay?
好，
好，
谢谢师傅见谅。刚刚你提到说，因为有那个狗的问题，所以障碍你来香港住，
是，
我觉得是可以解决掉，像那个同类疗法，在欧洲是很出名的，据说贵族跟英国那个英女王他们都是用这个同类疗法。
对。上次姐讲那个吗？
可以解毒，
解毒哦，
把那个西药的毒跟那些疫苗的毒解掉。
对，如果我们能把它带回去，让
那个狗的问题我们可以解决的。
我不知道了，
最主要你觉得你
我再想一想，因为总机场能带它回来给你们治疗呢，我不知道。
不是，可以有方法的，可以像它打针之前先给它吃。
哦，这样子
啊，它就会受到那个毒素的影响，然后
这样子
打完针以后可以再吃，然后可以把它毒素解掉了。
它
可以解很多的毒素，中毒或者重金属都可以解，都可以把它解掉。
真的有效吗？
真的有，这个是欧美国家那些治疗疗法的。
不过这个对狗有效吗？不是对人家有效而已。
我那个英文叫 homeopathy。
Homeopathy 我是现在有给他治疗了，是他那个。
那可以，我有一个问题，我想请问师傅，就是你现在最 concern 的某件事情。
在关心是什么问题？你又不晓得啊？世界末日 ，OK？ 还有那个气候改变了，灾难很多了，还要什么关心？谁都知道，还问什么啊？所以才要日夜那个打坐，我本来不用再打坐了，我打坐为了大家了，我现在不需要打坐了，听懂没有？我还是要的，每天平常是要五六七八次的，每一次越长越好。不过你们都是要求看我，比方说这样啊，要这个要那个饼干糖果啊 ，bedtime story 等等，这个以后就不能再要求了，懂不懂？什么时候能看就看了。平常是不是为了你们几个能够花那么多时间呢 ？OK 哈，那个上帝那个 God 在做不同了，他们不是这样子跟你们想象一样 ，OK。我也讲不完了，其实要讲讲不完 ，OK 哈、啊， yeah. 还有什么？就是这样而已哈。好、啊、OK， 你自己做打坐就会有答案了啊。
好、
啊，
我会的， okay. 我会的，一定会的，师傅，谢谢你。
当然我回答不完了哈、啊，因为每个人都有不同的问题，都是觉得自己问题最重要。我也很了解了，我也很了解，不过自己尽量。打坐就会有自己内面的答案 ，OK？ 不然师傅回答也回答不完的了 ，OK？ 今天你有这个问题，明天又有不同的问题，尽量静下来想怎么弄哈。我也要这样做的，其实有时候太忙没办法静下来了，你们自己会有办法，李师傅有办法可以静下来想的哈，会有那个答案啊 ，OK？
好的，师傅，我会尝试看看，因为我没有师傅那么忙，我有很多时间可以去打坐。
是是，好，太好了。我不是说你一个人了，大家了哈。
嗯。
会尽量 OK， 那边沟通是最好的。
你们里面什么答案都有了，就是没时间找了，然后一直靠师傅，我是靠外面的那个解决的方法 OK， 然后一直忙碌了，打招呼多啊等等 OK， 这要尽量好不好？
好。
无论怎么样，里面灵魂是已经自由了 OK， 剩下的就是没什么重要，今天头痛，明天耳朵，明天比如说肚子痛，那些就是 不怎么很，不管怎么样了 OK， 不是你们有好念头坏念头，那个也是次要的，反正主要就是灵魂解脱了 OK， 意境的时候解脱，不过你的灵魂现在也要指示你怎么弄的，就是你头脑不让它，所以有时候挣扎在里面，让我头痛肚子痛，我是生这个病生这个问题，因为我们跟我们的灵魂不合作，头脑了懂吗？习惯难改了，了解。哎，不过没关系，大家也尽量，我知道了，没有一个人不尽量的 OK， 就是我们人力有限嘛，身体有时候也累了，工作太多了，头脑也乱想啊，而且被世界事都有影响啊，所以随时要念五句保护自己，了解 OK。 你如果比方说你下地狱哈，记得念那个五句的话，马上就自由了 free， 听懂吗？比方说这样，不过意境的时候你们灵魂已经 free 了，就是尽量要听他 OK， 因为那个师父的力量跟那个灵魂比较好，现在很沟通了，就是头脑他不听，如果头脑做坏的话，也会影响到灵魂的那个等级了，就这样而已。所以讲有时候会挣扎啦，因为头痛啊，或是肚子痛，或是生别的病 OK， 有时候我们乱吃东西也会有影响，而是跟别人住在一起也会还会影响，如果等级不高会被大家事就会影响OK 啊，随时念五句保护自己，就是这样了 OK。
Telespectator nobil, ați urmărit acum iubirea unui maestru viu, ajunge la toate ființele, partea 1 din 3, din între maestre și discipoli. Fie ca toate ființele să se bucure de binecuvântarea divină. Pentru detalii mai multe, vă rugăm vizitați www.suprememastertv.com. Varu obliga BND.